Hey guys, it's Hunt for Games, and we did it. We're here. 3,000 subs. This is the official announcement video that we've passed 3,000 subs. Guys, thank you so much to everybody who has subscribed, liked, viewed, commented, briefly checked out this channel, and then gone to some better video. Whatever. Thank you guys so much. Your support has been incredible. The community that we've got in this channel has just been absolutely amazing. Seriously, I never could have expected to get to 3,000 subs. Couldn't have made it here without you guys. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. Seriously, thank you so much for all the support you guys give me all the time to keep going, keep doing new videos, and keep having fun with this. So, last time at 2,000 subs, I want to do a Q&A video again, a question and answer. we'll see how it goes, because the 2,000 video took like an hour to get through all the questions and answers. So, ask away. I might have to do like a bit of a question and answer speed run. We will see how it goes. Regardless, I'm going to answer every single question that comes out here. Ask me on in the comments below, Instagram, Twitter, direct message, however you guys can get a hold of me, whatever. If you answer, every video that I do live just happens like that. Ask whatever questions you want, seriously, about me. About my setup, my channel, my computer, what games I like to play, food I like, my puppy, whatever you're curious about, ask away. I will answer in the next video in about a week from today. So this is going to come out, Wednesday? Next video, the question and answer video will probably come out on Thursday of next week. So ask, let's say through next, like Tuesday or Wednesday, Tuesday. Might need 2 days to do this video. Tuesday. Ask your questions by Tuesday, and I'll totally answer them. Speaking of which, part two of this video, you may have seen the title and guessed at the topic. Giveaway. We're doing a giveaway. So, I really want to give back to you guys. You guys have been incredible. I wasn't joking when I said you guys are like the best community on YouTube. You guys have been amazing. Now, that might be because we're still like a smaller community. Like, 3,000 isn't huge. And as we get bigger, people might just start to be dicks. I don't know. Is that what happens? Do we just like, do people turn into assholes? But for now, you guys are amazing. I've so much enjoyed talking to you guys about all my favorite games and all the videos that I've been putting out. So to pay you guys back, I wanted to do a giveaway, but I've only done one of these and it was at 100 subs. So like 98% of you, that math is really bad. Someone do the math. That's wrong. I have not experienced one of my giveaways. And honestly, I didn't really like the format I did last time anyway. It was an Amazon gift card. It just felt kind of impersonal. It just didn't really seem like me. Like, even when I don't know, for Christmas, I don't even get that excited about getting Amazon gift cards. Like, it's a gift card. So, I wanted to do something, you know, in the $40 to $50 price range. But I put together this list of cool products, gaming peripherals. A lot of it's focused on PC stuff, but there are a few things that are good for consoles too. Gaming peripherals, I love getting this stuff. I think this is like the coolest, one of my favorite parts about gaming is getting a new controller or a new keyboard or mouse and like testing out all my favorite games with it. But I'm going to go through the list of cool things that I think I'd like to own. I don't own all of these. In fact, we'll get to the list. We'll get to the list. But anyways, here's how the giveaway is going to work. Like the video. Honestly, that's not even really required. Subscribe. You do have to subscribe. I have to be able to find you again. Subscribe. Comment on the video below with whichever of these products, whatever thing you want, you would want if you won the giveaway. Do it by next Tuesday. You have to do it on the video because I'll lose track if it's somewhere else. So for this, questions can come wherever, but your choice for the giveaway has to be in this video. So put your choice for the giveaway in the comments below. Subscribe if you haven't already. If you already subscribed, you're good. You're set to go. And by next Tuesday night, I'll randomly select a winner and I'll announce it at the top of the video in the description and in the follow-up video. I'll say like, you know, congratulations, whoever, and I'll reach out and contact you. So I think it sounds easy enough. I think it should be fun. So let's go through all the products. I'll list them below with like Amazon links to all these products. And if you're curious about looking them up and seeing which, I don't know, this is all weird. It's all new to me, guys. This is all new. I think it's gonna be really fun. I'm really excited. Also just excited to go through these products. I don't talk about products enough. It's one of the things I love most about like gaming and everything. So let's just get into it. One last time, and I'll say this at the end. Subscribe if you haven't already. Comment below with which of these products you'd like. They're all like 40 to 50 bucks. They're not all equal, so I guess you could go for the absolute most expensive one. But I think you guys are really gonna like this stuff. So let's start off. So first, the Steam Link. I don't have one. I'll show a little picture of it in the video. So I've got two of these things. I love them. If you haven't done it before, Steam streaming allows you to stream your PC games, all games that are in Steam, but also games that you just kind of add to your Steam library. A lot of those work too, like Final Fantasy 14 that I don't own through Steam. I play through Steam Link all the time. I was trying to make one of these for years when Steam streaming first came out and Nvidia streaming was a thing. Before that, just trying to stream games to other parts of my house. I love my computer and all my games on it, but I've got nice big TVs. Usually bigger than my gaming TVs, like in other rooms. And sometimes you're just lying in bed and you're like, I really wish I could play a game right now. But my PC is nowhere near my bed. It used to be like attached to my bedroom TV, and that was a good time. I'm getting distracted. Steam Link. So this thing is 50 bucks. Usually 40 to 50 bucks. I think right now it's like 44. I use this multiple times a week. I've got one set up in the living room and one usually set up in the bedroom TV. I'll quick hop on for like a trials roulette of Final Fantasy 14 or something in the living room if while Waffles is like eating food. It works really well. It is kind of dependent. I will say this, if you don't own one, it's really dependent on your home network and your router strength. If you've got an amazing router with some great Wi-Fi, this thing's gonna be great. If you don't, and you're not like hardwired some way to different sections of the house, this thing does, it could go either way. I haven't really used it on like some more difficult networks, but keep that in mind. But I think the streaming of games has been amazing. If your games on your PC are primarily through Steam, check it out. It's really cool. Even to just to get to another room, I love it. I use it all the time. Anyways, link below, Steam Link. Things are really sweet. Next, we've got the Logitech G600 MMO mouse. So I have always had the Razer Naga. It was like the first mouse that I bought that I like cared about, and different variations of that Razer Naga. It's basically the same thing as one I've listed below. The Razer Naga, because of the Razer branding, to be honest, is usually more expensive. But my buddy bought the G600, and I was like, I don't know, man. I've had some like touch and go with Logitech, but he loves this thing, and I've seen it in Houston, and it does exactly the same shit as my Razer mouse. So it's awesome. I can't go back to playing an MMO without this thing. If once you get used to hitting the number keys on the side of the mouse, you will never go back to another way ever again. Like I can't play MMOs, mouse and keyboard MMOs without it anymore. A lot of just regular games I play with that, and I like assign various functions to the number keys that I can just press on my mouse. It's really awesome. I know a lot of people are kind of turned off saying like, I don't know, 12 keys on the side, that looks like a lot. It's gonna be really hard to get used to. I swear, within like a few days, you just mentally start picking it up. Start with 6 keys, work up to 9, then get all of it's amazing. I love this thing. I could never go back. And my buddy has the G600 MMO mouse, and he says he loves it. So I think there's a couple different color schemes, but he swears by this thing. I love it. Also 40 to 50 bucks. Seriously, if you don't have a mouse like this and you play a lot of MMOs on PC, Final Fantasy 14 without a controller, any other MMO, please select this. I cannot sell it enough. Moving on. So the Razer Death Adder Chroma. If even after all of what I just said, you're like, I just don't care. I don't care about the buttons on the side. I'm not gonna use them. My keyboard has some cool macro functions and stuff that I use for that kind of functionality. I don't want it. I love the Death Adder Chroma. I don't own one myself. I've used it a couple times at a friend's house. Like I said, I got addicted to the side keys of the MMO, like Naga, but Razer says a lot of nonsense in their branding and marketing of like it's the most popular gaming mouse in existence. I don't know how to refute that or agree. That seems like a lot. But regardless, It is a fantastic mouse. It's awesome. It's really comfortable. I love the Razer styling. I've got a few Razer things on this list. My whole desk is covered. Oh, I hit the, sorry. The whole desk, my whole desk is covered. I got a Razer keyboard, mouse, this silly Razer mouse pad, the Razer Leviathan. I've got a lot of Razer stuff. I love Razer's styling. I think this mouse is beautiful. It's a really solid mouse without the extra keys, if that's just not what you're looking for. But enough about mice, mouses. Is it mouses when we're talking? No, it's mice. What am I even saying? That's stupid. Moving on. Another Razer product. So the Razer Kraken USB headset. So this is on this list for a couple of reasons. I've had a variety of headsets of all different brands over the years. Every single one I've had has had some sort of problem. So I constantly have to get new headsets. except though, I do have a Razer that I still use. It's my backup one right now. Only because I got like as a combo deal with buying some speakers and a really nice pair of headphones. But the Razers are actually still my most comfortable. They don't sound quite as good as the really expensive headset, but they are more comfortable. I love those. Again, I love the styling of this. The reviews are really solid for a $50 headset. Another positive though is that it works on both PC and PS4. I use the PS4 gold headset for that, going back and forth between PC and PS4, but that's more expensive. And honestly, the gold headset isn't without its issues too. I hear amazing things about the Kraken. Maybe you already have a headset and you're just looking for another one. Maybe you don't. I totally recommend getting a headset if you don't have one. And ever use just like earbuds that are attached to your controller or something, please. I think it totally makes the experience for any game. So, tons of fun. I just like it. There's like a bunch of different colors. You can check it out. So that's below the Razer Kraken USB headset. Then, little more towards the streaming recording side, if any of you are interested in that, but not necessarily just for that. The Ray Razer. It's not Razer. This is not Razer. The Blue Snowball Ice. Microphone. So I didn't realize this had come out until I was kind of looking through for stuff that I was interested in that I could add to this list. So it's $20 or so dollars cheaper than the standard Blue Snowball, which my little brother has. I have the Blue Yeti, which is the higher end mic, like usually closer to above or below $100. But my little brother bought this Blue Snowball and kind of made me feel sort of stupid because the Blue Yeti is really nice. But the Blue Snowball that he uses was like half the price and sounds great all the time. And I was kind of pissed off that I spent so much on the Blue Yeti, which I only use for PS4 recording. Now, this has a couple bonuses as a microphone that might interest you. So for me, first downsides. Compared to the actual Blue Snowball, it's almost identical. It has less directional audio features in terms of what you can change and so, like the Blue Snowball, you can change so it's like picks up the whole room or it picks up side by side. I don't know if that one's a feature or not, but regardless, the Blue Snowball Ice only is cardioid, which means like towards you, so one person. But if you're just using it as you've already got a great headset, but it doesn't have a mic, so you need a nicer mic for when you're like playing games online with people, or you are interested in recording or streaming or doing like Let's Plays and you just want to talk over some gameplay. This thing is great. The sound quality is awesome. You're not going to need those other directional features unless you get other people in the room. Honestly, they usually cause more issues. I always use cardioid mode for my Blue Yeti. So quality is there. It's an awesome little microphone. Plus, it's kind of cool looking. Check it out if you haven't seen it. It's just a cool little microphone. Plus, the PS4, if you have a PS4, recognizes the Blue Snowball. Recognized by my Blue Yeti, and it's actually how I do my PS4 recordings when I'm talking to my friends, is I plug the Blue Yeti into the PS4 with USB, and then I like listen via the audio jack to the feed. Actually, let me quick Blue Yeti, not Blue Yeti, Blue Snowball. Does it have? All right, so it doesn't have the 3.5 millimeter, but not as the regular Blue Snowball. I did, as I was looking at that, it does not also have the Blue Snowball standard comes with a minus 10 decibel kind of like extended range function that the Ice doesn't come with. I don't think it's going to kill anybody, but if you're looking for that sort of thing, then you might be let down by the iced version. Just be aware that there's two different versions. If you're really curious about the differences, somebody probably better informed than me could explain exactly what's different. Anyways, my little brother has the similar version and loves it. I think it's really cool. And like I said, it works on PS4, so even if you're just looking for a microphone, you already have a great headset, and you just want to sound better to your friends, to have them stop bitching at you, it's a cool little mic. So, talked enough about that. Last one before the default option at the bottom. The Corsair K55 RGB keyboard. I do not own this keyboard, but I did own its bigger brother that came with the mechanical keys. I stopped using it for only two reasons. A, I spilled water like all over it and the sound bar thing doesn't work anymore. And B, the mechanical keys were a little too intense for me. It was like... But it was really cool. I love the keyboard. I love the styling. And honestly, this is going to sound stupid, but I wanted the RGB to all sync up with my Razer stuff, so I ended up buying a Razer keyboard. That's kind of just... I feel sort of silly for doing that. But... The K55 is an awesome keyboard for $50. Seriously, I cannot believe when I was looking at this thing that this is only $50. Programmable macro keys, just like the Corsair, the bigger brother version that I had, which is always awesome for anybody playing a lot of MMOs. There's always something you can do with those macro keys. I love the volume slider. It's like a little scrollable, like... I just think it's a really cool, like, system. Anti-ghosting, obviously. It's a gaming keyboard, which... If you don't know if your keyboard has anti-ghosting or not, look into it. Once you've played on a keyboard that does, every time you play on a keyboard that doesn't, it feels like it's broken. Anti-ghosting means usually that you can press down multiple keys, almost always movement, without screwing up the other inputs. It means that if you're strafing and you go to jump or hit like F to kick somebody, you don't just like stop strafing. Because some keyboards have a maximum number of inputs that are allowed at one time. Some of them it's one, so you type like F, and as soon as you hit F, you stop moving, and that's killer for a lot of MMOs, a lot of games. It's tough. So if you don't have a cool gaming keyboard and you play a lot of games on PC with keyboard and mouse, please consider this. It's an awesome keyboard. I've used it myself at a friend's house, and I had a bigger brother, which just has different keys. It's really cool. I love the styling. I will warn you, it's massive. If it's anything close and looks exactly like the larger one, it's a pretty big keyboard. It's wide, so make sure you have a big desk, but it's a great keyboard. It's got a ton of stuff on it, like I said, and the RGB is just cool. It's got a bunch of different settings for how to set up how those lights display, so you can check that out, and let me know what you think. Last but not least, but it is least, if you hate all of these and somehow are still determined to find something on this list you like, I sincerely hope that you actually play games. I hope. So, Xbox One or PS4 controller. They're both like $45. Whatever your preference is, whether you use it on PC, the PS4, Xbox One, they're down there. Seriously, I totally forgot. If there's any color, any other color of any of these products that's the same price, let me know. I'm happy to get those too. You can include it down in the comments. Or when I speak with you next week, if you want, because honestly, I haven't bought it yet. So whatever you want, I want to get you guys what you want. This is for you guys. This is the giveaway for you guys. So, let me know. I know the PS4 and Xbox One controllers come with a bunch of different colors that are always often the same price. So, the blue snowball ice that comes in two different colors. That'd be new. So again, rules, if you missed it or something, subscribe. Post a comment with which of these products that I listed you'd like. Maybe a description of why would be kind of cool. I'm just kind of curious about why you want it, but it's not necessary. And don't forget about the question and answer that I'm doing next week. So yeah, same comment, different comment, whatever you feel like doing. Ask whatever questions you feel like. And I'll, you know, in the announcement of whoever won, I'll also do, you know, these two separate videos so I don't screw it up. Questions. Just ask your questions. I'm happy to answer. Again, guys, how long is this video? I've been talking for like 15 minutes about this giveaway. Guys, seriously, thank you so much. I cannot thank you enough. 3,000, next big milestone is obviously 4,000, but 10,000, 20,000. I've been loving doing this. You guys are the best. I'm obviously not going to stop playing video games. I can't see myself stopping making these videos. I'm having so much fun. Again, thank you. so much for all the support. Let me know in the comments what you guys are hoping to see. What do you guys want to see in the next 1,000 subscribers, the next 100 videos, whatever you, what are you guys hoping to see? I feel like 90% of you are going to say more Final Fantasy XI favorite Notorious Monster videos. But they're coming back. I did one last weekend. Don't worry, guys. They're coming. But seriously, let me know what you guys want to see. Thank you again so much for all your support. I am rambling now. We're just talking about nothing. Retro videos are coming. Not retro. Legacy? Oh, hold on. I want to play some nostalgic games. With like Let's Play style on Thursdays. Throwback Thursday kind of stuff. It's coming. Maybe this week. That might be the first one. Anyways. You got the rules. You got the products. Let me know what you think. Hope you guys like some of this stuff. And I'll see you guys in... I mean, in like 2 days for my next video. But next 1,000 subs. Have a good one. Have a good one. Peace. As always, guys, thanks for watching. If you haven't already, you should totally think about subscribing. I've got videos coming out twice a week, and if you like this one, there's at least a chance you'll like some of the others that are very similar to this, so live dangerously. Let me know what you guys thought about the video in the comments and other videos you'd like to see. And finally, follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Hunting for Games to keep up with all the latest stuff. See ya.